The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13384 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill, timetable for consideration. Any member who wishes to speak to the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion. Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak to the motion, therefore the question is that motion 13384 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13389 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme. Any member who wishes to speak to the motion should press their request to speak button now, and I call on the Minister to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, and I call on Liam Kerr to speak to and move amendment 13389.1. Up to 5 minutes, please.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer. I rise to request that a statement from the Transport Secretary be inserted at the end of the early finish this week on Thursday the 30th regarding the imposition of an LEZ in Aberdeen from the 1st of June. Presiding Officer, I requested such a statement at Bureau, but this was refused. I lodged a request for a topical question this afternoon, but I was not selected. I lodged a request for an FMQ on this matter on Thursday, but I was not selected. So this is very much the last resort, and indeed the last opportunity, hence my request to Parliament today. Presiding Officer, this issue must be aired, because from this Saturday, a large area of central Aberdeen will be designated as a low emission zone. A non-compliant vehicle entering that area will be subject to a financial penalty. Now, many have argued that the extent, the design and the area covered by this scheme must be rethought. And many suggest that it will discriminate against the likes of those of lesser means, the disabled, the unemployed. Many suggest that in a context where bus gates introduced last August 2023 have reportedly reduced city centre footfall by around 500,000, businesses and the already struggling Union Street will be further hammered. But perhaps most crucially, many suggest that the data upon which the Council has based its decisions is years out of date. It fails to recognise that Aberdeen's air quality has been below strict Euro standards for years, and it fails to account for the far greater emitters which will not be ameliorated or impacted at all by an LEZ. And the reason we need a statement on this is that Aberdeen Council's co-leader suggested that the Aberdeen LEZ was a direct imposition by the SNP government and could not be changed now. Now, last week, I was called for a supplemental question to another member's portfolio question, and the Transport Secretary offered a different view, saying there are flexibilities that can be made depending on the individual circumstances. It will be up to the council leaders in those particular areas to decide for themselves what makes sense for their cities. Now, that would seem to any observer like a clear and unequivocal contradiction of the Council's position by the Cabinet Secretary. And given the significance of this issue to not only Aberdeen, but also to many other cities in Scotland, it is imperative that the Council be helped to understand that they do have flexibility. They can rethink if the data, emissions and necessity has changed. So the Cabinet Secretary's statement could clarify where the misunderstandings lie, what data should be used, what variation might be appropriate under the legislation, and what the government's expectations of the council are in considering the likes of disabled people. Now, Presiding Officer, with an early finish on Thursday, MSPs will be in Parliament anyway, and no doubt eager to hear that statement. And let me be clear, it must happen this week, before the imposition this Saturday. I therefore, Presiding Officer, ask Parliament to agree with me to insert a statement on the Aberdeen LEZ by the Transport Secretary on Thursday at 4:30, and I move the amendment, therefore, in my name.
Thank you, and I call on Jamie Hepburn to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau. Up to 5 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I first of all thank Mr Kerr for bringing forward his amendment. This matter was, of course, discussed at the Bureau this morning, where there was no agreement for a statement being reached. Indeed, I could say it was not particularly pushed for at Bureau. But I did, at that time at Bureau, indicate that I am receptive to the request for a statement. I have no significant concerns per se about there being a statement, but I am unconvinced and unclear, despite Mr Kerr's closing remarks, as to the urgency or the necessity for the statement taking place this week. Briefly.
Liam Kerr.
Surely the Minister must concede that, given this will be imposed from Saturday, that we have to hear this now, before it comes in. And since we've got an early finish, presumably the Minister would be comfortable with that happening this week.
Minister.
Well, I'll return to the point about the scheduling of business. I think even he would accept, of course, that a statement this week is not going to change the fact about the coming of the LEZ. And there will still be plenty of opportunity, indeed there has been plenty of opportunity, for members to raise issues around low emission zones. And indeed, as the member will know, as he should know, the commitment to introducing low emission zones stemmed from a 2017 programme for government commitment. That is 7 years ago. There's been 7 years to raise questions about these matters. The preparation for low emission zones are very well advanced. They've been going on for a number of years, with both national and local consultations and extensive national awareness advertising campaigns. Matters such as our support for small business and the impacts of the low emission zone have already been answered in various questions by ministers in the Parliament. The Scottish Government is providing £5 million to reopen the low emission zone support funds for next year. This is the fifth year in a row the fund has supported low-income households and smaller businesses, with over £13 million having been paid out since 2019. On the matter of footfall, of course, Glasgow has been in operation since June 2023. The metrics there show that, from Glasgow Chamber of Commerce report, that weekends are at 100% of pre-COVID figures. Nighttime footfall is at 116% of pre-COVID levels. I'll give way once more, very briefly.
Liam Kerr.
I'm genuinely grateful, and I understand the point that he's making. The point that I'm very clear on is that it would appear that the council co-leader has misunderstood what is happening here. And that's why it's so important that that clarity is brought to this chamber and brought to the councils before it goes live.
Minister.
Well, of course, the Cabinet Secretary will not be held to account for the misunderstanding or otherwise of the leader of Aberdeen City Council. But what I would say, and I respect and under... One last time, very briefly.
Kevin Stewart.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I'll declare an interest, because I actually live within the LEZ area. I think that what we have here is a situation whereby we are seeing electioneering. And Mr Kerr's colleague, Councillor Lumsden, Douglas Lumsden, MSP, a former council co-leader, was ultra-supportive of the LEZ. What has changed in the time between him being co-leader and now?
Minister.
Just as the Cabinet Secretary cannot be held to account for the Council Leader's comments, I certainly cannot be held to account for Mr Lumsden's comments. And I think I have a minute and 15 seconds left, so with respect to Mr... And Mr Lumsden knows I'm normally very amenable to these things, but I have about a minute and 15 seconds left. So let me continue to make the point I was going to. There are obviously many means by which MSPs can scrutinise the activities of government. I appreciate that Mr Kerr sought to raise a topical question, sought to lodge a First Minister question. He will appreciate, of course, that it is not my gift or the Bureau's gift to determine whether that is accepted. Any points of concern can be raised during general questions at any point. They could be raised at transport portfolio questions, where the Cabinet Secretary for Transport has already answered a number of questions relating to low emission zones. And indeed, Mr Kerr made the point that he has had that opportunity. So I remain of the view that the case for this happening this week has not been made, is not a particularly strong or compelling argument. On the point about there being an early finish on Thursday, that's an indicative time. We still don't know how many amendments there will be on Thursday for Stage 3, so it might not be that we finish at that time. But what I can say is that I am more than amenable to facilitating a statement. I said as much at Bureau, and what I would commit to do, and I would urge him not to press his amendment, because I will bring back a proposition to next week's meeting of Bureau to schedule such a statement.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 13389.1 in the name of Liam Kerr, which seeks to amend Motion 13389 in the name of Jamie Hepburn, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, on changes to the business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.